I do realize that the title of this video was empties, beauty empties that I have, and I do have a box full of those in my lap. However, you guys can see behind me that I have, well, maybe a little bit, I have all of my palettes stacked up. That's the video that I am going to record right after this one that is going to be all about my eyeshadow palette collection and a huge declutter, I hope. I'm such an eyeshadow palette junkie that it's hard for me to declutter, but I digress because this video is all about what I've used up and whether or not I will continue to purchase those things in the future. Seems like everybody right now is just really trying hard to use up what they have. I feel like there's a couple of things that I really need to go through before I start buying again. One of them is makeup setting sprays. The other one is foundations, concealers, and primers. So all of those things I do have quite a few of, and so I wanted to show you what I've gone through so far. And then there's quite a few other like skincare things and whatnot. So no more blabbering on, let's get into the video right now. Okay, like I said, I do have this huge thing, this huge tub in front of me. I'm gonna just start with the one hair care. I think there was only one hair care thing in here. Nope, I lied, there's two. Okay, so this is from L'Ange, and I always say that wrong, but then anyway, this is the root booster, and it has this nice little nozzle right here on it. Hopefully you guys are gonna be able to see that. So you can just pick up your hair and then go right in the root, and then I just rub it in the root. I really did enjoy having this. It seemed to give my roots a lot of volume, especially when I did my hair upside down, blow dry my hair upside down. But the thing is there wasn't very much in here, and maybe I was just using too much. I don't think that's the case because I didn't feel like my hair was getting dirty or anything. But yeah, did enjoy that one, and I probably will try out some other root boosters, see if I can find one that may be a little bit better, you know, as far as the value goes. This wasn't terribly expensive because I got it on half price. Do you guys use a root booster? And if you do, let me know if you have a good one that you can recommend to me, because I'd like to know that. And then, of course, as almost always I have in these videos, is my minoxidil. And this is the extra strength, and it says right on the bottle, it says for men. Now, this does come with a squeezy tube dropper that I put into the next bottle when I use them. So that's in the other bottle. But use one dropper full. I use one dropper full at night to help regrow my hair. I've been using this for a really long time. I did go through that huge shed after I lost, you know, my over 100 pounds that I've lost. And I did go through that huge shed. I do feel like this did help regrow quickly because I have tons of little baby hairs starting everywhere. So this is really a product that's very inexpensive. I show it to you guys all the time and I continue to repurchase it over and over again. For skincare, I do have quite a few items here. Skincare is something that we all seem to go through so quickly, but at least we know once we go through them whether or not we're going to repurchase them. This is, I don't even know how to say this, but Cicalisse, I think that's how you say it, C-I-C-A-L-I-S-S-E. And it is from Emberlisse. And this was just a really super duper emollient product. However, when I did put it on my face, it stayed emollient for a second, but if I touched my face afterwards, like if I wanted to put an oil on or if I wanted to put anything on after, it was gonna ball up with this product. So this product I almost used all the way, but honestly, I couldn't even use it on my hands because it balled up so bad, and I was really kind of disappointed in that. So that one is a no-go for me. And so then I got in one of those holiday kits, the Lancome Genifique. This is the serum. This was a very small bottle. I think this is like 0.5 ounces. I don't really notice much difference with the Genifique compared to when I use my Ordinary Buffet or the Good Molecule Super Peptide formula, and this is so much more expensive. So I would say that this is not necessarily something that I'm going to repurchase, but a lot of people really love this one. So the next thing I put in a dupes video for the Strivectin neck cream, and this is the Gold Bond Ultimate Healing neck and chest firming cream. Okay, the reason that I put it in there is because the Strivectin neck cream is crap. And I'm sorry, but it balls up so badly that I don't even know how the product even goes into your skin. Because as you're trying to work it into your neck, it balls up terrible. And I was using this and I still rather like this. It's extremely emollient. It does say that it promises 97% of people had firmer skin at 2 weeks. I don't know, you guys. Once I lost the weight, my neck skin got really, really loose, and I'm trying to work with it. So maybe if I, hadn't had that happen, then I might have liked it a little bit better. That claim of being more firm, I felt like it was just super hydrating. And so I could feel like, it didn't look as yucky and crepey as normal. But as far as it being, like it's going to continue to firm my skin, I'm not sure. I'm going to keep trying other ones and I'll report back to you guys on that one. This is the Misha. This is the Essence Milk Sunscreen. And this is the 50 plus, whatever. And this I really did enjoy right up until I started feeling like it was a little bit too dried out. Now, if you are somebody that has normal to oily skin, this is fantastic as far as sinking into your skin so quickly and so beautifully, and it doesn't leave any residue behind whatsoever. And the nice thing about it that I found is it laid so well under my makeup. So I did find that during the summer when I was using it, I loved it, but when it got really dry where I'm at and the heaters came on and my skin got even drier, I found that I wasn't liking it so much. As far as if you're looking for a new sunscreen that does a great job on the sunscreen, but it also does a really good job of being, really good under makeup, this is so good. So light, so airy, sinks into the skin like a dream. And then I have two products from Pixie Beauty, and these are the vitamin C serums. This is the vitamin C serum, and then this is the vitamin C tonic. And both of these I really liked. I feel like when you open a vitamin C product, you really should be using it quite fast. And I don't really like that this one had a see-through bottle on it, because really when you do open up vitamin C, you can have it degrade very quickly. So I don't know that I'll be repurchasing this. I felt like it was a good product and I felt the little bit of tingling from it that you get. But as far as repurchasing it, I don't think I'm going to be doing that again. And then the actual serum, I actually did really like this, and it is in an opaque bottle, and I used the whole bottle and felt like it was still giving me the brightening that I get from my other vitamin C serums. So I'll kind of have to see. I'm always looking for the best vitamin C because I really haven't felt like I've gotten the best vitamin C I could get yet. And that, again, if you guys know about any vitamin C's that are fantastic, let me know. Dermatology. I know they take out all the vowels in there, so I always have a hard time knowing whether or not I'm pronouncing that right. So this is the Age Eye Cream, Age Perfect Eye Cream. And you can see it's all worn off. That's why I'm like trying to figure out what it says. But anyway, this is a very light product. I did not feel like I saw any huge differences in the crepiness and the dryness and the lines underneath my eyes. Or actually, at night I would put it all around my eyes. So I did go through the whole bottle of that. I won't be repurchasing that. I don't feel like it gave me anything, wonderful about my eyes. And then from Laneige, I have used their lip sleeping mask for a really long time, and I really do like this. This is probably my second or third bottle, something like that. And I really have enjoyed it. And actually, it's kind of settled being in my thing, so I think there's a little bit in there. I'm not going back in there, but I really do like this, and I really do appreciate how nice it moisturizes your lips. My problem is that where I'm at is so, so dry that this didn't work as well as it did when I lived in a different climate where it wasn't quite so dry. So I'm actually trying out some other lip things that I think are a little bit better. And then speaking of lip things that I think are a little bit better, these are from City Lips, and this is their lip glosses, and I used up two of them. And the clear one, and then this was like a beigey pink nude color, and I really do like these. They have a little bit of a tingle to them. They're really nice formula. I do think that these are a little bit spendy for a lip product, but they're actually more of almost like a lip treatment product. And so I was using them at night because I felt like they would stay on a lot longer. Well, obviously not going to eat, blah, blah, blah. And these would be on in the morning in this really, really dry climate. So I know that these are hyper moisturizing. And as far as them having a fragrance, they don't have a specific fragrance. They do have it's almost like they're trying to put a teeny tiny bit of vanilla in there, but I don't notice a fragrance that bothers me at all. And even the Laneige, it can have a little bit stronger of a scent. And I didn't tell you that. This one, I think is the berry one. And I don't mind the scents on the lip products. So, and that's not something that bothers me. But these are really, really good. I think that they do have a lot of properties that might help aging lips. And the other thing is get on City Lips email list. Anytime you get on email lists, you're going to find them for 50% off, or, you know, sometimes during the holidays, they have even more than that when they're clearing things out. So definitely if you're interested in these lip products, by the way, these were sent to me as from City Lips, and they gave me a whole huge package of stuff. And really, this is the only thing that impressed me enough to use them all the way up. So just so you guys know that, this is from Tarte, and this is the Double Duty Beauty Primer. This is a really nice primer if you need hydration. And this does have a very strong coconut smell. I got the trial size because I wanted to see whether or not it was one that I really liked for hydration. I do like it for its hydrating properties. I do feel like also that it doesn't like leave you sticky or anything like that. It does dry down and sink into your skin really quick. But as far as it being a primer for anything other than hydrating, it really isn't. So if you need smoothing, if you need pore filling, if you need makeup lasting primer, this really doesn't fit the bill for any of those. Am I going to repurchase it? No, because I feel like that it was just something that was an extra step for me because I moisturize the crap out of my skin. I'm saying the crap a lot in this video. Why? Anyway, I just moisturize my skin like crazy before I go in with any primer. So this is just kind of an extra unneeded step for me. But if you need extra hydration, you might really like that. Okay, here they are. I actually have four. And these are the setting sprays that I've used up. And I'm so excited. And actually the Kapari, this one is not a setting spray. This is the Coconut Rose Toner. Now, what I used this for, I didn't use it really as a toner. What I used it for is to really spray my face good before I put on any hyaluronic acids, because you need a little bit of moisture or a little bit, and anytime you use actually your skincare, except for your Retin A product, your tretinoin, you need to have your skin a little bit damp. And it's a good thing to have it damp like that, because other skincare is going to, you know, it's going to kind of prep your skin, get your skin ready to receive other skincare. So I used this and I really did like it, but I did not like that it was very fragrant. And that was really the only thing. It's a good product, but I don't think that you need that much fragrance in your products. And this was extremely fragrant, and I wanted to use it up because I did get it, I think it was like a year and a half ago at Ulta's 21 Days of Beauty, and it was time for me to get through this or get rid of it. So I finally did get through it. Okay, the next one I used up was the Dewy Finish. I'm checking to see if there's a scent. Is the Dewy Finish Setting Spray from NYX. I did enjoy this. However, I don't feel like it's, if you're super dry like I am, I don't feel like this is the dewiest product around. Just so you know that. Now in the summer, this probably would be really good for me. I do like this one. I am trying their brand new Radiant one as well. So I will keep you apprised of that as soon as that one is a yay or a nay. And then from Ofra, this was another setting spray, but this says Makeup Fixer. So it's a light refreshing mist that keeps makeup in place all day long. And it is. It's really nice. It's really light. It's really a lovely product. But as far as it being what I would repurchase, I probably won't. Again, it is the fragrance in here. This is the rose, and too much of a rose smell. Too much fragrance in there for me. I just feel like if I can get away from fragrances, that's what I'm going to be doing this year.
This is only $16
for 8 fluid ounces. I felt like that was a really, really good deal, and it lasted me a really long time.
Did it keep my makeup in place?
Yes. I felt like it was better than the Urban Decay All Nighter because it wasn't as drying as that.
So I do like that one, but I'll tell you what. This is my favorite besides the Flower Beauty Seal the Deal Hydrating Setting Mist. This one from Alginest, this is called their Splash, and it's their hydrating setting spray. This one is such a good spray. And the other thing I loved about this, I'm not getting rid of this. I'm going to clean it and keep it for other sprays because the sprayer was so fine. Oh, there's a little bit left in the trigger there. But the sprayer was so fine that I absolutely love that. And none of these other ones. I mean, I go through all kinds. I mean, I'm testing these right now for you guys to see what best setting spray is. I've had a few fails that are going to go into a fails video very soon, but if they don't have a sprayer on them where I'm not going to get spit at with that, like, you know, just squirting it and you get spit at and you have a big, you know, blotch of water on your face. Don't like that a bit. So none of these do that except for this sprayer and the Flower Beauty seal the deal. But I really do like their sprayer on that. And that is why I loved this product, besides the fact that the product inside was lovely, gave my skin all kinds of dewiness. Even though it set my makeup down, I didn't feel like I was being dried out. But yeah, I like this a lot and gonna keep the bottle just for that. So the other thing that I went through is a bunch of these Tinkle razors that I shaved my face with. I did do a video on that very recently and demonstrated that for you guys. I use these only about 3 to 4 times and then I, you know, get rid of them because I find that they are scraping my skin by then. And I love the fact that they are a straight razor. I know a lot of people have said, just get regular razors and do your face. I don't like that as much because I don't feel like I get as much exfoliating from just the straight rate from the regular razors versus the straight razors. So I really love having these. You can get them in packs of 3, 4, 5, 6 single packs, whatever. I buy them in bulk because, like I said, I only use them a couple times, excuse me, and they're not that expensive if you need to use them that often. This one is from Tatcha. This is their Silk Canvas Primer. I loved using this. This is chock full of all kinds of yummy good ingredients and I used it down all the way. I'm gonna keep this. I do have a teeny tiny bit in the corner there if you guys can see. I'm going to keep this because e.l.f. does have a dupe in their Poreless Putty Primer. It isn't full of the skincare ingredients like the Tatcha is, but again, I get my skincare ingredients more from my actual skincare items that I use than from anything like this. I don't mind Tatcha, but again, I think they're a little overpriced for what you get. However, it took me quite a while to go through this primer, and this is a full-sized one. So if you've been thinking about trying it, you might want to try their mini one. I know that they have that now. And then a mascara that I went all the way through was the Milani Most Wanted Lashes. This one got a little bit dried out on me towards the end of using it, which was, you know, about the 2, 2.5 month mark when I had to start replacing it. I love the effect that this did on my eyelashes. This was lengthening and thickening and held a curl. All of those good things that you really want from mascara. This actually made it into one of my videos very recently on my top 6 favorite drugstore mascaras. So this is one that I really do like and I probably will repurchase it again once I start going through all of my other ones. But yeah, I think I like this one better than 10-in-1. I think that's what it's called. And then there's one that's called Dangerous Lengths. I actually like this one a little bit better than both of those. All right, one more product. I went through a whole bottle of perfume, you guys. I never do that because I love perfume so much and I wear it every day, but I have so many. And when I got to the end of this one, I was like, wow, I'm at the end of that. But I've had this for a while, so it's probably a good thing. I am going to repurchase this one. This is the Viva La Juicy Couture Gold. And I love this fragrance, you guys. Love the bottle. But I love the fragrance. It is sweet. If you don't like a sweet scent in your fragrances, then you're not going to like this. But for me, Juicy Couture and the things that they've come out with, I have almost all of the I Love Juicy Couture ones. But this one, I can smell vanilla. I can smell just a tiny bit of citrus. I can smell some musk in this. So the notes in it are beautiful. And this is one. This is probably my favorite Juicy Couture one because I just love this so much. And so, yeah, I will be getting a new one of these when I can. But I am trying to use up all my other stuff first. One thing, you guys, I always turn you guys on to fragrance.net. It's the best place to buy any of your fragrances. I never pay full price for my fragrances. If you have a fragrance like this one, I just went on there to see if it was available and it was not right now, but you can put in a request and they will notify you once they get it in. So fragrancenet.com. Let me make sure I say that right because I get it kind of mixed up there. Okay, that is everything. You guys, I hope everyone's having a great day. Hope everything's going well for all of you. I love you so very much and I will say, oh, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up on your way out of here. I really do appreciate that. And if you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing. I'd love to have you here as a part of our family. Take care of yourselves. I'll see everybody in my next video. Love you. Bye.